try time. I'm in my car, I'm driving far. Try time.
Hey, and welcome to the second lunchtime edition of Drive Time with me, your host, Vern Howe. Live on the internet, YouTube.com, and VernHowe.com. We're going to get used to the heavy do the tape thing. I promise you, we're dealing with old technology, tape technology. It's still gorgeous out. I don't know, the temp, probably like 82. Not very humid. There's a nice, gentle breeze. I wanted to. I wanted to sing a song into my iPhone. I realized that I could do that and still have it show up on here. I have this project called Twitpella, and it's kind of garbage in a sense that the name doesn't make any sense because I guess I originally wanted to tweet an album of just really short acapella songs, and so it was called Twitpella, Twitter Acapella. I'm now in the third volume, of which the volume three has become a gigantic thing that's I'm gonna close it off at 500 songs. I'm at like 430 something now. Anyway, when I was walking out of my door after lunch, I had a nice, good, productive lunch. Followed my mantra, followed my heart, and it led me to having what I could say was a 100% successful lunch hour. And I wanted to sing a song in to my phone as part of this Twitpella thing, and also capture it for the Drive Time fans so you guys could see how the process works of me using the voice memo thing on my phone to record a song. But in the process of pulling out of my driveway and letting the theme song on cassette go, I totally lost all lyrics and melody. 100% gone. Nothing left of that. So I had nothing, I had nothing to sing. I literally picked up my phone, was looking for the app, was swiping and looking, and in that moment I realized, I didn't even have anything to sing because I had forgotten what the melody and lyric that had popped in my brain, I'd forgotten what it was. It was gone. Okay, changing topics. That's that topic, and then we're going to move on to other topics. Like I said, having a good day today. I don't know why. I'm even... you know what I should have done, though? I should have brought sneakers. I don't know how it's frowned upon to go on the gym bikes and things and flip-flops. We'll cross that bridge when we come to it, but yeah, even though I can't run really, I'm gonna take about a week off from running. I think we just use like machines at the gym, which I hate. I talked about this already today. What's the next topic? I was thinking about baseball. I've totally, 100% almost, become disinterested in baseball. And I remember, even not that long ago, I was a big fan. I was into it. I was a Yankee fan. Something happened in the last, I don't know, even just 2 years. I would say last season was the first season I just bailed on following baseball. Completely. It got to, I watched the playoffs. The Yankees were in, Yankees won a round last year. They beat the Orioles, and then they lost to the Tigers, yeah. And I thought it was compelling because everyone on the Yankees wasn't hitting and everyone was freaking out. And so, like, if the Yankees are in the playoffs, or just really only if the Yankees are in the playoffs, maybe if the Mets are in the playoffs too, I would get into it. But that's literally the only scenario. Oh, that was our first near accident on Drive Time. That guy kind of stopped short. He's lost. So that's my thoughts on baseball. I was like thinking about doing a, like I need another project, but I was thinking about like kind of like seeing if I could, I don't even know how to quantify this project or how I would even do it. So that's not gonna happen. Life is basically the movie The Matrix with Keanu Reeves. And, you know, when, you know, you learn that, like, you know, when he's in the, when he's, you know, he's Neo in The Matrix, that's like his perfect idealized self. And, you know, that is a great metaphor for what you try and do with life, is to know thyself. And, you know, even beyond knowing thyself is perfecting thyself, perfecting a life. Honing into what makes you happy. You know, if people legit, like let's say somebody's like overweight and they just like watching reality television, but they're truly happy. Like, you know, you can't tell them, they know they're like dying because of they're just like, they have diabetes and they'll probably be on like, they're very overweight and they'll have like heart and kidney issues when they're like in their 50s, but they're just like, I'm happy. And I'll deal with that when it's time to go to deal with the ending part of life. You know, their quality of life is fine in that, in so much as what they do, eating chocolate and eating a lot of carbs and watching, like, you know, bad television. Who's to say that's not a life? I mean, it's not the life for me. But who am I? Alrighty. Another one in the books. We'll be back later.